A creature that looks like the descendant of a dinosaur, over 10 feet long, weighing nearly 220 pounds, and it can take down a wild buffalo with a single bite. Sounds like something straight out of a sci-fi movie, right? But it is not. This is real, and that creature is still roaming the remote, rugged islands off the coast of Indonesia, a place where time seems to have stood still for millions of years. The Komodo dragon, the largest living lizard on Earth, is one of the strangest and deadliest predators nature has ever created. It does not need to sprint like a cheetah or crush its prey like a tiger or a crocodile. All it needs is one bite. Then it waits. Death will come eventually. Komodo dragons are mainly found on four islands: Komodo, Rinca, Flores, and Gili Motang, places with dry terrain, scorching heat, and very little vegetation. This is a brutally harsh environment where only the toughest creatures can survive. A fully grown Komodo can reach about 10 feet in length and weigh between 175 to 200 pounds, which is roughly 80 to 90 kilograms. Its body is covered in thick, armor-like scales. Its teeth are jagged, razor-sharp, and its claws curve like sickles. What is even more remarkable is its long, forked tongue that flicks in and out constantly, not to smell, but to taste the air and pinpoint exactly where its prey is, even from a couple of miles away. Think lizards are weak? Think again. The Komodo dragon reigns supreme in its habitat. It has no natural predators, and if it must, it will eat its own kind to stay alive. Unlike tigers or leopards, the Komodo dragon does not charge at its prey recklessly. It stalks, silently, sometimes for hours, lying still like a rock. And when the moment is right, it moves in. No need for speed, just close enough to sink its teeth deep into flesh. And that is when the nightmare begins. Inside its saliva is a biological weapon, dozens of strains of bacteria that cause severe infections, along with a venom that prevents blood from clotting, causes blood pressure to drop rapidly, and slowly drains the victim's strength. The prey might run, thinking it got away, but it did not. A few hours later, death creeps in from the inside, literally. And once the prey collapses, the story does not end there. Because a Komodo dragon never dines alone. The scent of blood rides the wind, traveling for miles, and soon more dragons show up. In that moment, there is no such thing as friendship or rank. Whoever is stronger eats first. The weaker ones either wait their turn, or risk getting knocked out, or worse, eaten alive if they fall during the chaos. They start their feast from the soft belly, tearing into the organs and throat, then move on to the skin, bones, and even the claws and fur. Their insanely powerful digestive system can break down almost every part of the body in just a few hours, leaving behind a crime scene with almost no trace of what came before. But even that is not the full story. A Komodo dragon can smell blood from up to 5 or 6 miles away, which is around 8 to 10 kilometers. The young, once hatched, must scramble up trees right away, or they are almost certain to be eaten by their own mother or siblings. There have been real cases of attacks on humans. A few have been documented on Komodo Island, where tourists or park rangers got bitten while they were not paying attention. Those wounds became badly infected. The blood loss was rapid, and things got extremely dangerous if first aid was not given fast. And about their speed, do not let the chunky body fool you. Komodo dragons might look slow, but when needed, they can suddenly burst into a sprint of about 12 miles per hour, or roughly 20 kilometers per hour. Fast enough to catch a deer or a stray dog that wandered too close. No roar, no chase, no brute strength, just one bite. And time does the rest. The Komodo dragon is living proof of one brutal truth in nature. To survive, you do not have to be the fastest. You do not have to be the strongest. You just have to be the last one, still standing. Now picture this, a full-grown wild buffalo, huge and muscular, weighing almost 1 ton, or roughly 2,000 pounds. It is slowly collapsing on a scorched, barren field, its eyes turning cloudy, breathing ragged and shaky, and then it crashes to the ground. There is no fatal wound, no neck-breaking chokehold, no high-speed chase. just a single bite from a Komodo dragon, a few hours earlier. That short encounter might not have seemed like much, but inside that bite were dozens of deadly bacteria, and even more devastating, a special biological venom powerful enough to make the buffalo disoriented, drop its blood pressure, and weaken with every passing hour. It runs, thinking it escaped. But the Komodo is in no hurry. It simply flicks its tongue, tastes the air, and knows. Its meal is almost ready. When the buffalo falls, it is not just one dragon that shows up. The entire forest seems to awaken. The scent of blood and death hormones travel like a call to arms. From a distance, hulking shadows begin to appear, slow but deadly, step by step. There is no order, no rules, only one law. The strongest eats first. The biggest Komodo gets there first, and unlike other predators, it does not start at the neck or hind legs. It goes straight for the soft underbelly. Within seconds, the intestines, stomach, and liver are pulled out, steaming and bright red. The others close in. They snarl, bite each other, claw, and fight over every chunk of meat. The weaker ones stay back, waiting for scraps. But sometimes, one misstep is all it takes. If a smaller dragon gets knocked down, it becomes the next course. The scene becomes a frenzy of primal chaos. The sound of tearing flesh, claws digging into dirt, heavy breathing mixed with guttural snarls. It is like nature holding a cold-blooded, slow-motion execution. You think Komodo dragons only go after wild animals? The truth is, they do not care. Wild pigs, monkeys, deer, buffalo, or even their own kind. If it is weaker, if it has blood, it can be eaten. Baby Komodos, right after hatching, must climb trees or risk being devoured by their own mother or siblings. It sounds unbelievable, but this is one of the most extreme cases of cannibalism in the reptile world. And do not think humans are off the menu. There have been reports of Komodo dragons attacking tourists, park rangers, even local villagers. Some people only took a few steps behind their house and never returned. One bite, if not treated quickly, can lead to necrosis, severe infection, or toxic shock. And the scariest part? Komodos do not just bite and walk away like a tiger or a leopard. They will follow that scent of blood to the very end. They do not stalk for sport. They do not kill for fun. They were born to survive in the most ruthless way nature could ever design. They do not need speed. They do not need perfect aim. They do not need dolphin-level intelligence or wolf-like teamwork. They only need to wait. And then, the victim's own cells will finish the job for them. There is no other predator on Earth that uses time itself as a weapon as effectively as the Komodo dragon. And believe it or not, we still have not covered all the bizarre things about this animal. A female Komodo, completely isolated from any male, can still lay eggs and produce offspring. This rare ability, called parthenogenesis, allows the species to survive even when only one female remains. And here is the kicker. A Komodo dragon can live for over 30 years. And in all that time, it has just one goal: live, eat, and rule. In the wild, there are plenty of infamous predators. Lions with their unmatched strength in numbers, leopards with perfect ambush skills, and crocodiles with the most powerful bite force ever recorded. But the Komodo dragon is different. It is not the strongest, not the fastest, and definitely not considered the smartest. What makes it one of the most terrifying creatures on the planet is the slow, merciless way it kills. One bite that does not even have to be fatal. One touch that does not even need to be precise. Then it waits. That incredible patience is exactly what sets the Komodo dragon apart. It can follow its prey for hours, even an entire day. Just watching as the animal weakens, collapses from exhaustion, and finally crumples onto the dry, cracked earth. That is when the dragon calmly approaches. No need to rush. The meal has already been marinated by the venom and bacteria in its mouth. In nature, it is incredibly rare for a predator to use infection and time as its weapons, but the Komodo has turned it into an art form, a strange blend of ancient instinct and evolutionary precision. It may seem out of place in the modern world, but in truth, it is the ultimate product of natural selection. When you look at how a Komodo dragon lives, it sends a chill down your spine. A creature that can eat its own kind without even blinking. A mother that would devour her own eggs if she feels undernourished. A world where the weak, even if they are siblings, only have two options: climb a tree or get eaten. And yet, in all that brutality, the Komodo dragon has survived for millions of years as a living relic of prehistoric times. It has not had to change much to adapt. Because the environment around it is so harsh, everything weaker has already been wiped out. Maybe the Komodo dragon exists to remind us of this truth. In this world, the winner is not always the strongest. It is the one who knows how to wait, strike at the perfect moment, and do whatever it takes to survive. Now imagine this. You are walking along a remote, sun-scorched island trail. Just up ahead, on the other side of the path, there is a dark shape lying still. It looks like it is just taking a nap under the blazing midday sun. You turn your back to walk away. But what you do not know is that it has already flicked its tongue. It has already sensed your presence. It has already picked up the scent of blood. And if you were to slip today, if you were to get hurt, even just a little, then maybe, just maybe, your story ends as a survival tale that never gets told. The Komodo dragon does not need to chase. It does not need to roar. It does not need to stand out. All it needs is to endure, no matter the cost. That is the true peak of survival, and that is exactly why the Komodo dragon deserves its place as one of the most fearsome and mysterious predators on Earth. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.